So this is the API gateway pattern. And it is really easy if we have the single instances of these microservices. The problem will occur how to handle many instances of these microservices. So of course, we can put some external load balancer, for example, HProxy, Nginx, between them and push all of, pass all of the requests from API Gateway through the proxy, and the proxy will load balance the request to the instances of microservices. But what happened if we would like to scale our gateways because the load of the users will increase? So should we add more load external load balancers, or should we just proxy to the same load balancers? The problem is with this load balancer, this external load balancer becomes our single point of failure. So what about the idea that we can attach the load balancers as the part of this API gateway, and it can be dynamically changed to the cluster changes, and it can watch the new instances of microservices? So this is our idea. And we looked for existing solutions. There is a Netflix Libron. This is the client-side inter-process communication library, but it's written in Java and doesn't support backpressure, all this stuff. There is the DCI Minuteman, the layer 4 load balancers. It is really great and used in DCOS, but the problem is that you need, it's not on the application level, it's the DevOps level. And another idea is, for example, Mesosphere's Marathon load balancer, but it's just a wrapper on HProxy, and it still needs DevOpsing over that to figure out how to run. And of course, the problem is that if you are using these solutions, you are really sticky to the platform. So in the third one, you are sticky to the DCOS. In the second, in the third, you are sticky to the Mesos. In the first, you are sticky to the Netflix solutions. So let's implement it with Akka Streams. And some constraints we would like to develop is load balancer can handle events about new endpoints. I mean that if there is a new endpoint up of microservices or new endpoint down, we would like to dynamically change the state of the load balancer. Load balancer will dynamically reconfigure endpoints. That's what I say. Load balancer will proxy requests to current endpoints, and load balancer will support back pressure based on Akka streams. So, who of you is familiar with Akka Streams and use it? Okay, so just a small summarize. In Akka Streams, we have three parts. There is a source, a flow, and the sinks. The source is the part which is the source of some kind of messages, and these messages can be exposed to another port by outlet. This part is called outlet. And the messages from outlet can be passed to the inlet, and the connection between these parts is back pressures, which means that this outlet demand the new messages from publishers, so from the source, and this source will push it. So the all connection is back pressured. And in my example, we'll use the source, the flow, and sinks, of course, because we'll have a source of endpoints, we'll have a source of requests. And finally, on the right side, we'll have the sync for HTTP responses. So we have looked for existing solutions for that. But Akka Streams told at the beginning of the manual that you shouldn't try to implement your own graph stages, because it is possible that you can compose everything with existing graph stages. But in fact, there is no solution in current Akka Stream implementation for some kind of dynamic flow which can dynamically change during the changes of some other inputs of endpoints, for example, or requests. So the thing we would like to develop is some kind of load balancer stage, which will have two inputs, the endpoints input and requests in. And finally, this load balancer will watch these endpoints, will reconfigure its internal state, and proxy the request to the proper endpoints, and then pass away responses out. So that's what we'd like to implement right now. Okay, so I have prepared a simple test for this. This is a load balancer test. And how our load balancer look like?
Our load balancer is the object which would like, which has the method flow, and this method takes the source of endpoints. What is endpoint? Endpoint is just a host and a port. And what we'd like to return is to return the flow of HTTP request and write of HTTP responses. That's why we are returning the flow, which will take the HTTP request, and it will return the try of HTTP responses, because sometimes the request can fail. So this is our idea, and we would like to implement this. Let's take a look on the test. So load balancer should take, should load balance requests over the endpoints. And how we can test it, I have prepared the endpoint mock. Endpoint mock is just a single instance of HTTP server. So here it is, here is a code which make it start. So HTTP bind and handle async with a handle. We've provided endpoint host and endpoint port. And what is the handler? Handler will just handle the request. Yes, stop the thread for 100 milliseconds and then push the response. So this is only the mock of the endpoint, HTTP server, some kind of service. And what is more, what we are making here, we are processed, increment, and get. Well, it could be just increment. So you are counting how many requests was processed by this endpoint. OK, so come back to the test. So we are preparing two endpoints. We are setting up two endpoint mock. And what we are doing here, we are creating 10 requests. We are setting up the source. So we are setting up that there will be a source of endpoint one and endpoint two. So this is the source of endpoint. And here is a source of request. So we pass this list of requests. So we have a source of HTTP requests. What can we make next? We have a request source. We push this elements from this source via load balancer flow, which we are going to implement, and then we run with sync secu. So we are pushing all of these HTTP responses from the flow to the list. And finally, we have the future of secu of try of HTTP responses. So we are awaiting about 5 seconds to complete. And what are the checks? Finally, we'd like that all of them will be a success. So all of tries will be success. The count of the responses should be 10 because we have pushed 10 requests. So we're expecting 10 responses. And what is more, we want to implement load balancer. So it means that we are making a round robin load balancer. So the first mock should process 5, and the second mock should also process 5 of the requests. Great, so we can try to run it. And of course, there will be a lot of times when our test will fail, but finally it becomes green. So, okay, the first step is the implementation is missing. Let's take a look. So of course, there's no implementation for our method. In order to make it, we would like to implement our load balance stage. Okay, so we are going to implement load balancer stage. In order to implement load balancer stage, we are extending the grab stage. And the grab stage requires the shape of the graph. As I showed on the picture, the shape will have two inputs and one output. So we are expecting fan in shape two. The first will be endpoint. The second input will be HTTP request, and the output will be, of course, try of HTTP responses. Great. Okay, let's import it. And load balancer require from us to implement some methods. I will remove this. Okay, the second method we will bother later about this, and the first method is the shape. So we need to define the shape. So we are making new fan in shape two. And what does it require? This requires the inlet one, inlet two, and the outlet. So in our graph stage, we need to define this inlets private val. The first inlet will be endpoints in. So this is the inlet on the presentation here, which will hold all of the endpoints in. Inlet of endpoint. And what is more, we need to name the inlets in order to have better debugging later. So we can name it load balancer stage dot endpoints in. Okay, then we need other inlets and outlets, so we need the problem is that I can't see my code. Okay. Request in. So we are expecting HTTP request. In. And what is the third and the last is request out. So this is outlet, of course, of try of HTTP response. Responses out. Great. And we can finally implement our shape, which is endpoints in, requests in, and responses. Oh, my fault. Responses out. Great. So we have finally implemented this. Let's see what will happen when we try to run the test. Of course, nothing more, because we still need to implement this flow. As we would like to prepare the flow of a graph stage, so we would like to make a flow from graph. And what is the problem? Our load balancer, we are taking here the endpoint source, and we are expecting to return finally the flow. So we need to use here the Akka Streams graph DSL create, which will take this endpoint source. This requires us to have to pass the builder, and here we should have endpoints. Does it work? Great. So here we have the source, and the pleasure part of the Akka is that this DSL is really great, so we can make something like this builder add, and what we would like to add to our graph. So we would like to add our new load balancer stage. It doesn't need anything, so here we have a load balancer, and we can make some connections. So we need to import graph DSL implicits, and what we would like to do, we would like to connect endpoints out to a load balancer in zero, and finally from this graph we would like to return flow shape. Okay, which will be in one, so this is this inlet for the HTTP request, and we would like to return LB in of load balancer out. Well, it seems that it's okay, so let's try to run it one more time. Of course, there is new next implementation missing, but here. So the stuff we would like to make there, okay, is to implement our logic. So we are creating a new graph stage logic. This requires us to pass the shape we have created so far, this variable. And let's try one more time. Okay. No handler defined in state blah 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 for port responses out. So this is the next part. How can we implement this logic of the dynamic load balancer? Means that we have all of this inlet and outlets, and we need to create the logic what should happen if someone will request some request from one outlet, etc., etc. So what we are going to do in the scope of this graph stage logic, we have something like set handler. And we can set handler for inlet and for outlet. So we can set the handler, provide the function, what should happen if there will be a new element in endpoints in. So basically, what should happen if we will get the new element, which is the new endpoint which we have process? Or what the logic, what should happen when there will be the new request? So let's start. We need to inlet, we need two logic for inlets for requests in and endpoints in and request in, and we need an out handler for responses out. So let's try. The most important part is that all of the stuff which will occur within this brackets is thread safe, because all of the graph stage is coupled in, is will be done within the actors, so all of this stuff and implementation is covered by actor and its features. Okay, so let's start to implement this in handler. It will be endpoints handler. In handler. Okay. And what does it happen? Okay, so if we set the endpoints handler, endpoints in, so we are coupling the endpoints handler with endpoints in endpoints handler. So how does it work? When there will be any new element here, endpoint, in the inlet of endpoints, there will the method onPush will be invoked. So here we should implement the logic which is intent to handle what should happen with new endpoint. From my experience, it is great also to override these two methods on upstream finish and on upstream failure, which right now we will leave just in this implementation, so we just skip it. Internally, on upstream finish is called when the source will just finish, the elements in the source will be finished, and on upstream failure will be called when upstream have some failure. Here, the upstream, we are thinking about the source of endpoints. Great. So on push, what should happen on push? We'll see later. Of course, we need to define another endpoint handler. So requests handler, new in handler. And I suggest also to override this method, as we would like, we don't want to have this default which are implemented internally by this stage. And also we need to responses handler, new out handler, and final override. Here we, on the out handler, we have only the method on downstream finish. So we'll be, our stage will be let know about that downstream has finished working. So we shouldn't process any, we shouldn't push any new stuff. Okay, set handler to requests in, request handler, and set handler to responses out, responses handler. So we have handlers. Let's see what will happen right now. Of course, we're lack of implementation, but the errors about shouldn't be done. So there is implementation missing on pull. So it seems that our test has started, and when we come back to test, it seems that our sync secu, which is our sync, want to pull, so it requests the element from the flow. And yes, it's done finally, because the method onPull, so the downstream wants to pull some element. Okay, so let's start to implement all this stuff. What should happen when the new endpoint wants to come to our logic? So we can do it in another method, handle endpoint. Okay, dev. Okay, when this method will be invoked, we would like take the element for the inlet, so endpoints inlet, endpoints in. Great. And the next step which we would like to create, we should create for this endpoint a connection to this endpoint. So I would like to introduce the class, for example, connection, which will take endpoint grade. And what we would like to do, we would like to new connection. And the next step, we should save this connection somewhere. So to we can import Scala collection mutable. We can use it within this logic because it's thread safe. And we are creating connections, which is mutable Q at the beginning empty of connection. Great. And what we would like to do is to connections and queue connection. And finally, the most important stuff is that as we have grabbed something from endpoints, we would like also to pull new elements. So if our stage has already taken an element from the endpoints inlet, we also want to call the upstream to please give us one more element. So we are here requesting the new element. So this is the implementation of handler endpoint. Request handler. Try handle request. Great. Dev request. What we should done if there is a new request? Of course, we should grab this request. No, we shouldn't grab the request if there is no endpoint which can handle this request. So first thing which we can do, we can go through the connections and make the queue first, which we don't have any implementation of the class, but which is ready to push, just that we would like to push the new request to the connection. There is no implementation. We'll implement it later. So we have this, and for each connection. So we have this connection. If we find the connection, we have found the connection, we would like to then grab the request, val request. Great, we have this request. We would like to push to the connection. So we would like to connection push request. Of course, there is still no implementation, but we'll implement it in a couple of minutes. Connection push. And the next step we need to make is, of course, to, as we have the queue, the connection from the queue, so we need enqueue it one more time. So connections, enqueue connections. This will make us this round robin in the queue between available connections. And the next step is, of course, to pull request in. So we need to make a demand for new request because we already have handled this request. And the final part is try handle response. Try handle response. When we should handle the response. So there is a demand from the downstream, but it is ready to handle the response. We can handle the response if the connection has processed the request and we have a response. So if how to check it. So we are trying to dequeue the first connection, which is ready to grab, because we would like to grab an element from the connection. Okay, and what we would like to do next is to, if you find this connection, we'll just make connection grab and pull. And what we are going to return? We are going to return the try of HTTP response. So try of HTTP response. So this connection will be responsible for taking a request, push it through the Akka HTTP, and return our the try of HTTP response. So we are grabbing the element, the response. So we have this response. And the next step we would like to do is to push it to responses. Responses out, which element response. And of course, we should enqueue our connection connections and queue our connection, which we have already taken from the queue. Great, so far it is implemented and we have a logic for our endpoints in, requests in, and responses out. Let's see what will happen right now. It is just stacking for, of course, this await 5 seconds. It means that there is no, that we have probably implemented everything, but it doesn't work. Why not? Because we are waiting for the status of this graph stage, but this graph stage should also make a demand. So I mean, this graph stage should tell upstreams the endpoints in and the requests in that he wants to handle, for example, new endpoint, or he wants to handle, for example, new request. So we can make it in pressStart method, and the only thing we would like to do there is pull endpoints in and pull requests in. So we are telling some upstreams that this stage is ready to handle our requests and and endpoints. Let's see what will happen. Oh, it fails? Great. It seems that our code has reached which places? Sorry, I can't see. Okay, here. So it's ready to, so it seems that something is working. So the next step we would like to do is to implement the code of connection. Okay, thanks to Akka, we have all HTTP stuff implemented, so we can implement the flow HTTP. We can use the ready-to-use implementation of HTTP. It requires a system. A system, how can we pass the system? Or we can just pass as an implicit to this class. Great. I can hide it. Okay, so here we have this system. And for this example, we are going to make only a single connection per endpoint. In our solution, we have this configurable. In these places, we'd like to have only the single connection, where, of course, to the endpoint, host, and endpoint, endpoint port. So here is a flow which is able to handle, to pass the HTTP request and return the HTTP response. How can we use this flow with these methods? So developers of Akka has thought about this, and we have some kind of special structures for that. It is called subsync, so we need something like subsync in. It's not case class. Oops. Well, it is not available. Sorry, subsync inlet. It is called subsync inlet. So this is, we are going to make our connection as a subsync and subsource. It's better to tell. We're going to make a connection as a subflow of this our main flow. And we can do it with this DSL and API. So the subsync inlet will handle HTTP request. We also need to name it, so we can name it something like this. Endpoint in, and we would like also out, subsync, subsource outlet, and this will be HTTP response out. Okay, and here we are going to make a flow of source. I think that this is the most tricky part here, but what we are going to do is from graph. The graph will be out.source. It is hard to understand how it works, but it works something like that. We are created the in and out, so some sync and source, which will provide us really useful methods to just make a flow between all of these parts. So we have created a source. We would like to push request via flow, and we would like to run it with, of course, our sync, and it requires from us materializer. which is now, we know that every stream in Akka needs to a materializer. You can use it a materializer or subfusion materializer, subfusing materializer. This subfusing materializer is, has a special algorithm and it makes this much more faster. Okay, why it doesn't work? Okay. Interesting. Happens much expert. Dot shape. No, because it's a go outgoing connection of phone. This is the out source. Okay, this is the source of HTTP response of fused. This is a flow. What is the problem? The problem is type expect flow shape. Not in the third. Oh, it's tricky. Oh. To be honest, I get weird because it's not, never happened before. Okay, let's. Oh, yes, sorry, yes, it should be a response, my fault, and it should be HTTP request. Yes, it works right now, my fault. Great, so we have created this flow, this connection flow, a single connection flow, and in order to start to the flow to run, we would like to use this in, pull. So we are making the demand on this side in order to take some spaces, place some stuff from the source. So how can we handle and implement these methods? So is ready to push. Is ready to push means if you can push an element to this connection, so out is available. This is the method which tells us if we are able to push something to out. Great. How can we implement is ready to grab? It means that we would like to return true if there is an element already processed. So it means that we have a response. So in is available also. How can we handle push? Well, push is really easy because the only stuff we would like to do, we'd like to make push this request. So we are pushing the request and grab and pull. So we'd like to take an element. So we'd like in grab response. So here we have the response. We would like also to make a demand because we have already use the demand, and here we are not going to implement any error handling, so we are just returning the success of response. Of course, if, for example, the connection has been closed, we should return here a failure or some special stuff. So it seems. Oh, of course. Great. Thank you. So everything looks okay, and the next step we would like to do is to run our tests and see what happens. Mm-hmm. Great. Oh, quite an exception. Why? Because this, I don't know why there is no special error handling, but this subsource outlet means that you have no handler configured here. Okay, so we can come back to our load balancer stage. Great. And what we are going to do, we need also to provide handlers for this inlet and this outlet. So it's really easy. In handler, new in handler. So what we should do on the on push and well out handler, new out handler. Great. And what we are going to do is to configure this handler. So for our out, we would like set handler out handler, and for our in, we would like also set the handler in handler. Great. And we would like to make some, what we should do if there is called on push. So it means that we would like to push something to in. So there is an element ready to, there is a response which we can hold. So we would like to just call the method up. So we would like to try handle response. Because if there is an element in this sync, so it is probably possible that we can take the response from this connection and push it to our responses. What we should do with onPulse, so it means that connections can take a new request, so we only need to try to handle requests. There's one important thing. This can be called regardless of the state of the and this response is out. So we need to make certain that this response is out is available to handle our response, and the same we should do also with try handle to request. So we need to be certain that request in is available, so there is an element to take. Okay, so we can try to run it, and we will see what will happen. Oh, cannot pull closed port. Strange, because it tells us that request in, we can say where, it means that we would like to pull a port which is closed. Why the request win is closed? So we can take a look at load balancer stage test. And why is it closed? Because we have a single source of request. So we have a source of list. The elements of the source is only the 10. The length of that list is 10. So this source will complete as soon as it push all the elements, but it doesn't mean that we have processed all of this request. So how can we protect against this this error that we would like to take one more time? We would like to pull request in. So we can just make a check that we shouldn't pull is closed request in. So of course we if it's not closed, then you can pull it. Let's try it one more time. What will happen now? Okay, and one more time it stacks. Why it stacks? And this is the problem, because if we take a look at the test, we are going, the sync secu is waiting for all the elements, and as soon as all the requests will be pushed, we push it via the flow, process it, and push it to the sync. When the service of the request will finish, is empty, it will call the on upstream finished. So we'll take a look what load balance stage on upstream finish. What end requests handler and what we are making, what we are doing on upstream finish? Nothing. Basically, we have override these methods. In common cases, what the default implementation we just called complete state. So let's see what will happen if we just call complete state. So we're just stopping our processing because upstream is empty. Okay. It seems that something is working. What is the problem? Head size 6 instead of expected 10. So it seems that we have pushed all the requests, we have processed the request, but the flow has finished before we have respond with all of the responses. So it means that we are completing the stage too fast. So what we are going to do, we are going to make some kind of trick. Oh, it's not a trick, it's just an implementation which should be done here. So we would like to have a flag which is false. Finished. So we would like to mark that our stage is finished, and we would like to try, have a method try complete, try finish, which should be implemented how? We are making this method dev try finish. Okay, and if finished, and what? And when we are certain that all of the responses have been processed, so we would like to introduce something like in flight count is lower or 0, then we are completing the stage. Okay, so we need to implement this inflight count. So we are is 0. And what we should do? We should, when we are taking the new here request, it means that we have some request in process. So we are going to increase the inflight request count. Of course, when the response will leave out our stage, so it's here, we are grabbing and pushing into the responses out, we are going to inflight count minus one. And what is more, we would like to try to complete the stage as soon as we have already processed some inflight requests. So we'll try to call try finish. And try finish will check if it's finished and inflight count is lower than zero. If it is, we are just complete the stage. So we'll finish the processing step. And it seems that if I run the test right now, it works. So yes, it works, and it is not so hard to implement this kind of logic with graph stages, and thanks to its DSL of the stuff here. Of course, there is no error handling, etc. It was done by us in our open source solution, but to be honest, it's really great, and what is most important, it is dynamically reconfigurable, so we can come back to our presentation. I don't know how much time I use, but I have implemented this load balancer in 10-20 minutes. Okay, we have implemented this, and what about some extra stuff? Of course, inter-service communication in microservices environments can be done with a lot of approaches. One of approach, and it can be called anti-pattern, but sometimes it's needed, is that you would like to have a couple of instances of services, of profile service. Oh, there's a mistake. For example, this is a profile service, and this is the cluster of user service, and each of them can have its own load balancer connected to this service, and thanks to that, we don't need an external load balancer as the single point of failure, because each service can listen on endpoint changes, can reconfigure its load balancing strategy, and can load balance the request to the service. This also increases our high availability, because if, for example, this service will fail, here still we have another instance on the service. Great. And how can we manage the source of for endpoints in? I mean, how we can handle this endpoint? So, for example, you can have a service registry, for example, console. When every service, when it came up, it will register itself, and then other services can query this service registry, will take the new services and push it to the source of the load balancer, and then load balancer will reconfigure internally, and everything will work. Of course, you can subscribe to the system of event bus, big thanks to that we are using this, the source of endpoints, so you can use any kind of source which are already implemented in Akka. For example, we can use a source of WebSocket, and we can retrieve the new endpoints for load balancer with WebSocket from another source. And of course, for testing, it's really easy. Like here, we can use just a list of endpoints, so we can have a static list of endpoints which can be used for load balancing. So thank you very much. We have so far implemented this Akka HTTP load balancer. We are all working on that. It is already deployed in production with more than 30 services running, and everything works. So we are really happy, and it seems that yes, you can do a lot of great things with Akka and Akka Streams. So thank you very much.